This land is your land. This land is my land. From California, well, to the New York Island. From the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. I tell ya, this land was made for you.
I mean, my God, didn't we settle all this manifest destiny bullshit over unequal rights in the 60s and 70s? Come on, doesn't pimping out foreigners get you feeling a little bit sleazy and tacky already? I don't know about you, but I'm getting a bad, nasty 19th century vibe from all this.
Call it what you may, misguided, short-sighted. And let's call it what it is. It's hate. Trying to diminish the people, diminish their worth, and diminish what power they have in the culture that exists. But the fact of the matter is, you can't do that. Because right here and right now, this is a movement of love.
As I was watching, now they tried to stop me. They pulled up a sign that said, oh, it said private property.
We are here outside of the Arizona Diamondback Stadium where Ken Kendrick is running fundraisers right now to support the SB 1070 bill. This bill is infectious to our community, and we're letting everybody know that we do not stand for this bill. Brown is not a crime. We're out here today to let people know, as a part of 30 days of summer rights, summer of human rights, that we are gonna not stand for this bill, and we are here to stand and fight.
It's a really strong presence, and we really want to build it because it's happening all across the country and all kinds of other Diamondback games. People are coming out, and we really have to build it here in Phoenix. We've got to keep all these balls in the air, the boycott, the Diamondbacks, the Wells Fargo, all the events that are going on. We just have to keep going because this is where it's at, you know, this is why we're doing it.
Well, in the shadow of the steeple, down by the welfare office.
The pattern of which really is reminiscent of the Jim Crow laws in the South. They're really designed to intimidate people into not voting and being defensive in terms of their rights and not providing the kind of freedoms that are enjoyed by most Americans. And I think we need to characterize them as such, because that's exactly what they are. They're reminiscent of the Jim Crow laws.
It's illegal. It's what part of illegal do you not understand? Man is supreme over laws. Man was not created for the law. The law was created, was made to serve man. And when the law harms man, or and women, of course, that law, it needs to be disregarded and disobeyed.